Welcome, city enthusiasts and travel aficionados. Today, we're diving into the vibrant heart of the Big Apple, bringing you the top 10 must-do experiences in the city that never sleeps, New York City. From iconic landmarks to hidden gems, we've curated a list that captures the essence of this bustling metropolis. So, fasten your seatbelts, because we're about to embark on an unforgettable journey through the streets of New York. Let's explore together. Number 10 Statue of Liberty and Ellis Island. The top spot on this list may not be a surprise, but there's no doubt that both of these attractions are a must when you're in New York. The Statue of Liberty is the symbol not just of New York but of America. And Ellis Island represents our nation, too. After all, almost half of Americans can trace their ancestry back to this one island. There are many options for viewing the statue from the harbor, but I recommend taking the time to go to Liberty Island to see it up close. You can visit the Statue of Liberty Museum and climb the pedestal for incredible views. From there, it's a quick ferry ride over to Ellis Island to explore the Immigration Museum and learn more about this gateway to America. Both islands have a unique experience to offer that you should discover for yourself at least once. You can always visit the Statue of Liberty in Ellis Island with a guide to make your visit that much richer, adding in historical context and local insight, but however you choose to visit, these two deserve top billing on your NYC bucket list. Number 9 Broadway. The theater district is home to over 40 Broadway theaters, which is why New York offers some of the best live theater on the planet. Whether it's a new musical, the latest smash hit, or the long-running classic, seeing a Broadway show transports you out of your seat and into a new reality. That's the magic of Broadway. One of our guides shared lots of great insider tips for exploring the area in our Broadway Behind the Scenes blog post. He has a few suggestions for tickets, but know that although prices may be steep, there are ways around it. For example, you can visit the TKTS booth in Times Square or sign up with TodayTix for discounts on the go. You can also tour Broadway with a real live NYC actor to learn more about the stories and secrets that make NYC's theater district unlike anywhere else in the world. Number 8 Brooklyn Bridge. Walking the Brooklyn Bridge is an easy, fun adventure and the perfect excuse to visit Brooklyn. The views are unparalleled, and the bridge itself is a wonder to experience on its own. If you want the best views, start off on the Brooklyn side and walk towards Manhattan. It keeps the view in front of you and starts you off with less crowds. This gives you more of an opportunity to relax and enjoy the scenery. If the weather is nice, consider taking your stroll as the sun sets and you'll see the skyline of Manhattan glitter to life one building at a time. Number 7, Central Park. There's nothing that beats a sunny day in Central Park. Definitely save this one for a nicer day. Rainy weather doesn't allow you to truly enjoy the beauty that is essentially New York's backyard. Take a stroll through the Ramble, pay tribute at Strawberry Fields, go skating at Woolman Rink, picnic in Sheep's Meadow. You have plenty of options, and you'll see other New Yorkers out here doing the same. Visiting Central Park is a great way to get a glimpse of authentic NYC life. While rain might get in the way of a good time at the park, don't let cold weather stop you. Central Park in the snow is classic New York fun, and ice skating here in winter is magical. But you'd hardly notice the four major crosstown thoroughfares, which cleverly disappear into foliage-covered tunnels. Map your park route to stop at classic Central Park landmarks like the Bethesda Fountain, Bow Bridge, Belvedere Castle, and the Strawberry Fields John Lennon Memorial. Number 6 Little Italy in Chinatown. One of the many wonderful things about New York is its diversity, and that is what you'll experience when you visit Little Italy in Chinatown. The best part? These two completely different neighborhoods are right next door to each other. That's the beauty of New York, you get to enjoy two equally fascinating but totally different neighborhoods within mere blocks of one another. Lots of people visit both these neighborhoods in the same trip. We do for our neighborhood tour, adding in Soho as well. Since they're so close, you can get a taste of each in under an hour. Of course, you can stay a lot longer if you want to have lunch or dinner here. Little Italy has seemingly endless options for pasta, pizza, and pastries, plus a few annual celebrations that really bring the neighborhood to life. Coming from the Italian flavors of Mulberry Street, you'll cross over Canal Street, the heart of Chinatown. Chinatown is like a city within a city. Chinese food, shopping, medicine, decor, you'll find it all here. Whether you spend an hour devouring a box of roast pork or duck from street style before you have to proceed elsewhere, or you spend half a day shopping for produce, dining out, and paying a visit to the Museum of Chinese in America, everyone will gain something from a visit to Chinatown. Number 5. Metropolitan Museum of Art. New York is chock-full of fascinating and historical museums, but the Metropolitan Museum of Art manages to stand out among the others. It's the largest art museum in the United States and among the top visited museums in the world. The permanent collection alone has over 2 million works. Its halls are filled to the brim with art and culture, so you can spend a day here and not see it all, though in this guide to the Met, we try to cover everything you should see while you're here. The Metropolitan Museum of Art is also conveniently located at Central Park, so it's near another must-visit attraction on this list. Guide tip: the Met entrance fee is pay what you will, so it won't break your budget. Number 4. Grand Central Terminal. Arguably one of the most beautiful buildings in all of New York, Grand Central has come a long way from its opening in 1913. About 750,000 people pass through this place each day, making it one of the biggest and busiest stations in the entire world. Its size is impressive, but its architecture is worth admiring, too. The highlight is the main concourse ceiling, which soars 125 feet above you, showcasing a mural of gold leaf constellations. Be sure to take some time to stop outside, as the facade of the building is equally beautiful, a standout among the shiny, modern towers of Midtown. Number 3. The High Line. One of New York's most unexpected attractions is tucked away on the west side of Manhattan. It winds back and forth along 10th Avenue and soars 30 feet above ground. Welcome to the High Line. The park was completed in 2016, so it's fairly new to the tourist circuit, and honestly, still not on most tourists' travel itineraries. Stretching from Gansford Street in the Meatpacking District all the way up to 34th Street, the park is built on a former industrial railroad. As you walk up and down the paths, you'll notice various species of plants and the original tracks themselves snaking in and out of view. Number 2. 9/11 Memorial. More than any other city in America, the events of September 11th impacted New York in a way that's still felt today. But rather than linger on the tragedy of the event, the 9/11 Memorial reflects on our healing and growth as a city following the day. A moving piece of artwork called Reflecting Absence, two memorial pools stand in the footprint of the towers surrounding the museum on either side. And around the memorial, you can't help but notice all the amazing new buildings that have been created to rebuild what was lost. The 9/11 Museum is one of these, another must for your visit if you have the time. Both peaceful and somber, the 9/11 Memorial and the 9/11 Museum are both no doubt emotional to experience but is ultimately a beautiful tribute worth visiting. Number 1. Times Square. Square in Midtown Manhattan, New York City, formed by the intersection of 7th Avenue, 42nd Street, and Broadway. Times Square is also the center of the Theater District, which is bounded roughly by 6th and 8th Avenues to the east and west, respectively, and by 40th and 53rd Streets to the south and north, respectively. Known early on as Long Acre, also spelled Longacre Square, it had an unsavory reputation as the center of illicit activity in the 1890s, though earlier in the 19th century it had been both a commercial and a residential area. The square was renamed in 1904 for the New York Times, which opened its new offices in the Times Tower on the square, though it would outgrow them by 1913. Almost immediately the square became the place where New Yorkers gathered to celebrate the arrival of the new year. In 1907 the Times began lowering a huge glass ball down its flagpole at midnight on New Year's Eve to mark the occasion. Throughout the years, ever more sophisticated technology was used for the square's ball drop as the tradition came to include live television broadcasts that shared the experience with tens of millions of people across the United States. And there you have it, folks, the top 10 things to do in the concrete jungle where dreams are made of, New York City. If you enjoyed this whirlwind tour, don't forget to hit that like button, share with your fellow adventurers, and subscribe for more exciting travel content. Have you experienced any of these activities or have your own favorite spots in NYC? Share your thoughts and recommendations in the comments below. As always, thank you for joining us on this journey, and until next time, keep exploring, keep wandering, and keep falling in love with the magic of travel. Goodbye for now.